331.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know where to begin on this fifth day of May 2014 live worldwide broadcast. I don't know where to start. There is so much news, so much to break down, so much unfolding. As we see the conversion of our society from a somewhat free system to a totally authoritarian, oppressive, unfair, unjust, fraudulent system, as in the days of Noah, so will it be in the days of the coming of the Antichrist. To paraphrase a quote out of the Bible, and I was saying that because I saw a story from The Blaze up on drudgereport.com. Are the end times upon us? Author says, unrestrained immorality mirrors pandemic godlessness seen in the Bible. And I thought, instead of looking at all the news that's unfolding, and we will, the White House Correspondents' Dinner, Obama's latest sickening jokes about Rand Paul and the Bundys, Ron Paul exclusive interview up on Infowars.com. Common Core is really the last straw. Getting into the fact that it's a deliberate plan to dumb down our youth. That's what Ron Paul is pointing out. I know you know that and I know that, but the general public is just now realizing this is a premeditated program. Also, Patriot Group protest Cinco de Mayo ban on American flag T-shirts. All over the country, public schools say you can't have an American flag T-shirt. That's up on Infowars.com. CIA and FBI worked with fascists in Ukraine as war in Europe unfolds. I mean, you've got massacres, 30, 40 people being killed a day, mainly by the pro-Ukraine government forces. Again, I'm not endorsing the Russians, but they didn't start this. And most of those areas that are in eastern Ukraine were part of Russia historically. Again, Ron Paul's article, exclusive interview, former congressman slams deliberate plan to create dumbed down, obedient population. Obama supporters say not liking Mexican food is racist. I'm not kidding. Students say it's illegal to wear an American flag shirt on Cinco de Mayo. Like, this is all a free speech issue, and we actually have that video as well. Coming up in the next segment. I think I'm going to get into the whole First Amendment issue and really project forward into the future and ask, what type of balkanized country is this where you can't have an American flag T-shirt, period, in many areas, not just on Cinco de Mayo, and how effective the establishment has been at creating division in this country. Israel wants to give Mount Zion and the Tomb of David to the Vatican. That's a Michael Schneider article up on Infowars.com. Ron Paul has another article up on Infowars.com. Why we are no longer number one. And I've been so busy just trying to put out fires around here and complete a bunch of projects that I haven't even had time to slow down and just pull back from everything. And say, where are we as a civilization? Where are we going? What does your gut tell you is going to happen? My gut tells me war, depression, massive change. And that's what all the British Ministry of Defense documents say, the Pentagon documents say. That's what the Pentagon futurists say as a foregone conclusion. But the globalists have created a society where they want that to happen. And then there's this attitude of, okay, let it all collapse. But when it all collapses, people aren't going to really think that. There's this decadent attitude of just let the devil take it. But once the devil takes it, you're not going to like it. So I think I should open the phones up today for first-time callers and ask, what do you think the next year, the next decade, the next 50 years holds? Looking out in the future, give us your futurist perspective. In fact, we're going to do that today after we get into all the news. And there is a lot of it coming up. Again, ladies and gentlemen, it's Monday. We're live.
Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
The globalist social engineers are not just targeting us with propaganda. They are manipulating our genetics. We are being targeted at every level by estrogen mimickers that lower our testosterone and other hormones and natural compounds that the body needs. After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic super male vitality formula sourced from powerful organic herbs and then concentrated for maximum potency. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose. For a limited time, we are offering 15% off Super Male Vitality at InfoWarsLife.com to introduce you to this powerful supplement. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality. InfoWarsLife.com.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosates that is found in water supply. Supplies worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139.
Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches.
He aligns himself with the truth, and it's time for you to choose a side. You're listening to Alex Jones.
Sorcerer of death's construction. The body's burning as the war machine keeps turning.
Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central.
Death and hatred.
We are live, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining us on this Monday, the fifth day of May, 2014 edition. Here's what's going to happen. I want to talk about the big picture. Not just the, 35-plus people killed in one day this weekend in Ukraine, mainly by pro-Western, pro-EU, pro-George Soros forces. More helicopters shot down, obviously, by Russian forces. The civil war that is starting over there by design. Obviously, when you talk about the stock market decline, how it bounces up and down, but overall is declining when you add in devaluation of the currency. And all the other cooked numbers on unemployment, inflation, you name it. We've got the evolution towards tyranny in the public schools, where children in their own free reading time or at the library are not allowed to read the Bible, but can read the satanic Bible. Clear backpacks distributed to Franklin regional students because you're all criminals. We have to know what you have in your bag. Criminal until proven slave. Not guilty until proven innocent. Not innocent until proven guilty, as it previously was. First, it's innocent until proven guilty, then guilty until proven innocent. Now, guilty until proven slave. Guilty until property of the state. Guilty until dominated by tyranny. Florida teacher banned Bible from free reading time in class. And then it ties into articles like this one. Too big to audit, large partnerships escape IRS scrutiny, GAO reports. That's because in the last 20 years, in phases, they've gotten rid of almost all of the IRS investigators for billionaires and multinationals. Because the billionaires and multinationals lobbied to have enforcement against them shut off. And people will say, well, Alex, I thought the IRS is criminal. It is criminal. It's a collection agency for the private Federal Reserve. But if you had fair enforcement of the fraudulent tax, then the elite wouldn't always be lobbying for higher taxes because they're exempt from them. And they get your money in corporate welfare and government contracts and no-bid contracts. That's why all the big billionaires, except for the Koch brothers and a few others, that's why they're demonized and attacked. I'm not saying they're angels either. They just don't lobby for that. They do lobby for their other interest. That's why all the major billionaires, except for maybe Peter Thiel, who's Bilderberg, and Mark Cuban, who's a billionaire, more liberal, but at least more libertarian liberal, and just a handful of others. There's hardly no one out there who isn't a multi-billionaire who doesn't lobby for higher taxes. Because if they don't, the globalists come after them and try to shut them down. Because Warren Buffett and David Rockefeller and all of them and Henry Kissinger and the big British and Dutch royal companies, their wealth is a state secret, the British and Dutch royalty, their cousins. And I don't mean to digress off into this. I got stacks of news. It's just too big to audit. Large partnerships escape IRS scrutiny. GAO report confirms, and it goes on to break it all down, CNS News. This is the issue that we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen. There's some good news on the free speech front. High court ruling favors prayer at council meetings. The Supreme Court said Monday that prayers that open the town council meetings do not violate the Constitution even if they routinely stress Christianity. Well, you know why? Because it's an elected council and they reflect the will of the people. The court said 5-4 decision that the content of the prayers is not significant as long as officials make a good faith effort at inclusion. That's right. You can't say no Muslims are allowed here or no atheist. An atheist can come forward in their 3-minute communication and they can say, I hate God or don't believe in God or blah, blah, blah. And a Muslim can come forward and say, I believe that, you know, Allah is God and Muhammad is his prophet. And a Christian can come forward and say, I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Or you can walk forward and say, I like milk for 3 minutes and talk about how a big, frosty, delicious, ice cold cup of milk is so good at midnight with the cookies, but not good for your waistline. You can walk up there and talk about how you're an ornithologist and love Tweety Birds. You can talk about whatever you want under free speech. And folks, separation of church and state under Thomas Jefferson, who I agree with, says the state cannot make an official religion. That's the First Amendment. They've turned that into the state runs religion and controls what you can say and what you can do. Now, what you don't want is a public school officially saying you've got to recite the Bible and recite it as if, you know, saying you accept it. But that's not happening. Under Common Core, all over the country, they are making children recite the Quran and making them pray to Allah and bow to Allah. And this is just done as a litmus test to see, can we do anything we want with these kids and will the parents accept it? Forced inoculations, abortions without parental consent, taking down the American flag on the week of Cinco de Mayo because it's offensive, illegals pulling it down from flagpoles all over the country. This is all meant to test you and see what they can get you to go along with. Now, that said, the first thing I want to get to is a report out of CBS News. It's up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And here is the headline. Students say it's illegal to wear an American flag on Cinco de Mayo In response, Tea Party groups plan to protest. And you know what I want my reporters to do today? We were back there having a meeting.